Will you welcome now a lady? Will you welcome now a lady who's guaranteed to brighten up any party? The gorgeous, the adorable, the delightful Lily Savage! Give it to me. I'll put it down here.
Thank you.
Put it down. Oh, look at him. What's his name?
Buster. Good lad, sit down. Oh, shut up, Arden. Why do they say a dog they go mental?
Well,
pack it up.
The British.
No, they're all posse.
Pet lovers is what they are.
I couldn't leave him in the house because he mounted the turkey, so I had to bring him out with me. Honest. And also.
Can you get a bit near? It's as though you'd sort of gone off me or something.
No, not
there
at
you
all.
Are.
I'll tell you. You see, also, I wanted to emphasise, because you get all these mad parents who go buying dogs for the kids, don't they? Yeah. But that a dog is for Christmas, not for life.
Yes.
I mean, a dog is for life, not for Christmas. Yeah. You know what I'm on about.
Yeah,
yes.
I know what you're
anyway,
on.
Anyway,
yeah.
Sit down. Don't do a whittle, will you?
No, we had enough problem with a camel.
Do you know what I want for Christmas?
What do you want for Christmas?
Julio Iglesias, head-to-toe in leather. That's what I want.
Yeah, what do you want?
Des, I was walking down the corridor past his dressing room and I could feel my drawers sliding down my legs. It's an involuntary reaction, honest to God. It happens with Tom Jones. I'll be in a record shop and they play Delilah, my drawers are off, honestly. Oh, Vera. No, my sister Vera.
Oh,
she
I
went
know
to
Vera.
See Vince Hill, you know. No, she's got to think about Vince.
Vince
Hill, you know, remember Vince Hill?
Of course, I love Vince.
Edelweiss. Anyway. She took her drawers off, Croydon Fairfields all, and she flung them at him. Honestly, 100% cotton, reinforced, double gutted from hotels in Exmouth Street. They shot across Fairfields up, stuck to Vince Hill's face. He was like John Hurt, an alien. Honestly, never worked again for months after that, the shock.
Listen,
now he's chilled out. You,
right? He's very comfy now, isn't he?
Oh,
hey, Buster, just call it Buster. He knows his name, doesn't he?
Well, you'd know your name and all.
Is he?
Yeah.
Yeah. Has he got girlfriends or anything like that?
Now and then he has a little fiddle behind a bin, but nothing serious.
He's sort of nodding off now.
You'll have a little kip, love, yes. Yeah. See, if I leave him in the house, he dials 0898 numbers and smokes. You know what I mean?
This Christmas.
Yeah.
This Christmas, Lily, you're in Blackpool?
I love it.
You don't mind?
Love it. It's my spiritual home. Honestly, I love the place, yeah. Because I was there, you know, I was
there
for summer season.
You did the summer there, didn't you?
Des, I was in the North Pier Theatre, which is a Nissen hut on a pole in the middle of the Irish Sea. And I got out the van, I took the blankets off my head, and I got out the van, and I looked in the middle of the sea, there's this thing, it looks like Alcatraz, honestly, it does. It looks like Devil's Island out there in the sea. And there's a tram takes you down the pier. Now, all the time I was there, when I was in the theatre, the tram was always at the other end. And when I was at the other end, the tram was always down there. And yet I never saw it move, almost. I swear to God, if you want to commit suicide, throw yourself on the tram lines of the North Pier because you've got about 3 hours to think it over before anything comes. But that place, wicked place. I'm doing a Christmas show up there.
Yeah.
Kids. Got 12 kids.
With dancing and all that. Is it panto? It's not a panto.
I think I'm getting up at 10:30 in the morning to come out the floor just as a wicked queen. You've got another thing coming. No, I don't like pantomimes.
You
no,
don't like pantomimes.
No,
so that's not for you.
No.
Do you enjoy Christmas? Is it something that you say, you look forward to? So?
Hate it.
No, you don't hate Christmas. I don't believe you hate Christmas.
No, I don't like it. I've got to be honest. And also, I think the true meaning of Christmas has gone out the window now, don't you? Because if on one side of the telly you had Silence of the Lambs and the other side of the telly you had Thor Ahead and Alan Jones singing Carols from Winchester, we'd all watch Silence of the Lambs, wouldn't we?
We would indeed.
I can't say blame you like for it, because I... But, like, when you think of poor Mary, what she went through all them years ago, dragged through the desert on the back of a donkey, pregnant, right, get there, there's nowhere to sleep because he hasn't booked. You know what it's like at Christmas? You can never get a room anyway. So she carted off to a stable, right, left on her own, gives birth. What happens? Three fellas in dressing gowns kicking the door in with bubble bath and chocolates. For God's sake, the woman's just had a baby. What's wrong with the baby walking and a bit of Milton for the bottle? I mean, it's not on. And where's he? Joseph, he's up in a field with the shepherds. And then he says, oh, come down and see the missus. And she's lying there with the baby. And the sheep and camels all over the place doing their business. There's a loony on the roof and a nighty singing away with a manger. Get off my roof! That poor woman went through that so we could give each other bath cubes. Now, would she do it now? Don't like it. Don't like it.
An interesting point of view.
Do you know what I'd love with the Queen's speech? What? If she made it just after her dinner. You know what I mean? So she sat there, pogged. She's like, dying to belch, and she can't, right? And now they have the camera on her face and her desk with a picture of somebody, and you see out the back, you know, up the gardens and whatever. If they just took that camera away and panned round the room, so you see Princess Margaret on the couch, unconscious. Unconscious. Lying there with a gob open. And a pair of ski pants and men's socks. Just a big line of spit hanging out of a gob. Queen Mother lying on the floor playing Scrabble. Now that I'd watch.
Changing the subject.
To something more delicate.
Yeah, well, yeah. Not delicate, more, I wouldn't even say seasonal. Everybody seems to have a video out, and there's a rumour going around that you've done a fitness video.
Me? No, I've got a video out, but it's not a fit one. Seriously, no. Don't have to exercise when you watch it and things. Do you know, I bought this video when we were in Blackpool, me and Sonia. We bought this one for buttocks, right? Seriously.
Buttocks?
Buttocks, you know, your bum. You know,
yeah, like, yeah.
And what you have to do is, you have to clench, like that. So she says, when you're standing at a bus stop, clench. Literally, you stand there. I'm clenching now as I'm sitting here talking to you, honestly.
The dog's turned away.
The couch is going to vanish in a minute. Look, I'm clenching. No, he's clenching, is. Come on, boss.
Is he all right?
Oh, he's having a ball. Go on, boss, clench.
We all clench together.
You lot clench. All clench.
Have a little clench.
One, two, three, clench.
And at home, clench. That's better. Oh, the dog's turned round now. He's feeling up.
So we're clenching, right, yeah. All the way. Me and Sonia sitting there clenching away, clenching in the street. And at the end of this video, this woman says, by the time you've watched this video, she said, you'll be able to hold a pencil between the cheeks of your buttocks. And I said to Sonia, what would you want to do that for? So when you're washing the dishes, you can write a letter, don't you? So we're doing this, but in agony, clenching. Honestly, I could have peeled a spud with mine by the time I finished. Honest to God. Honestly, I could have made chips out of a spud. Waste of time, so no, I haven't got a fitness video.
That's not your idea. Yeah,
they're all the same, aren't they?
Are they?
These middle-aged women in leotards going, and hormone patches flying all over the studio.
Big thank Lily and Buster.